Okay, we are back for the fourth game, or maybe third game, because I count Mario Kart as a game, but it's not such a long game and the same kind of game as first-person shooters and obviously Bond. So this will be the third Bond game now, won't it? I thought, come back to GoldenEye, and not the new one. Obviously, we've just done the N64 one, not the one that wasn't released, but yeah. Do some GoldenEye Reloaded. And I thought, because I did put Nightfire into the PS2 and was ready to go. And then I thought, I could maybe do World Is Not Enough on N64, because the N64 was still plugged up. I was just looking at the 360 and thought, I suppose I could do one on 360. And yeah, and just to go on to a newer console would be nice. And just to play through GoldenEye again already. And then perhaps after this, eventually, I'll go on to the new one. So yeah, let's get into it. Okay, so yeah, this and 007 Legends I've only got in a CD holder case, which I realise I've got a lot of 360 games in this CD holder case, because I stupidly got rid of loads of cases. I kept the games, but got rid of loads of cases, and this and the other Bond game happened to be one of them, so I kind of forgot about it, really. And I think I've only played this through once. I don't really remember anything about it. Obviously, I know it's GoldenEye, so we already know what we're in for, pretty much mission to mission. And it's got the same kind of mechanics as like a Call of Duty game of the time, I guess. So I think it's easy for people to kind of just compare it to Call of Duty, in which case they might say, oh, it's rubbish. But you know, it's supposed to be a Bond game, not part of that kind of franchise. I just realised I could have pressed A ages ago. Okay. I don't think this wouldn't have loaded anything. Loaded a save kind of thing, because I've got a different 360 since then. So if we do single player, new game. Oh wow, 007 Classic. Wow. Wounds do not heal and body armor must be utilized. Yeah, that's cool. So that's like a traditional GoldenEye, I guess, isn't it? You lose your health, it doesn't replenish. I would be tempted to go for that, but I think that is going to be, yeah, that would be very hard. So I may change up the difficulties on this, like I've done in previous games. Like, I think with Agent Under Fire, I went for Agent, and there was only one mission I couldn't do on Agent that I put down to Operative. But I think I really don't know, because on the one hand, I don't want it to be too easy, you know. I don't want to just get through these games like walking through them. I want that to be a bit of a challenge, but not so much that, like in past videos, I've been retrying levels and stuff. So maybe let's go for Operative, and if it seems like, you know, get through the game as we get through the game, if it seems really easy, I'll put it on Agent. So I try not babble on too much either with a lot of these things.
Good morning, 007. Welcome to the MI6 Ooh. Agent Evaluation Center. As you know, this course is mandatory for 00 agents, and only the best will remain certified for field operations. Good luck. Take the weapon from the counter, 007.
Oh, yeah. Carry two other weapons in addition to your standard issue P99. Oh. Oh, God. Okay. It's a good point. I can't remember many tutorial levels in Bond games. I'm probably wrong, but oh yeah, yeah. Bond, walk over to the counter and pick up the two additional weapons, which are an AK, yeah, and a. Thing. SMG? Sigmas?
Keep going, 007.
Okay. Sorry, these aren't probably, this isn't the best video to start with, I guess. A tutorial level. But yeah. It's all good. Oh. Saying that. Oh, okay.
Move on, 007.
Any secrets going on? No. Can we silence it from here? Oh, yeah, get on. Oh, there we go. This is cool. Like I say, I think I've only played this once before. It was at a time where I was just obsessed with gamer score, so even if the game was brilliant, as soon as you got the most you could out of it, you had moved on. So it's sort of nice to have not played it that much. It seems really nice so far. It's basically Daniel Craig just in Goldeneye, so yeah. Right, need to remain undetected to pass this section. Okay. Can I knock him out, or do I have to shoot him? Or do I have to shoot him or knock him out at all? Yep. Loving the music as always. Way ahead of you. Although I did think it was going to fail the mission, though. Shooting the camera. You've been detected when you are detected. Direction of the enemies that have spotted you will be marked. All right, yeah.
Good work, 007. You passed with flying colours. M will now brief you on your next mission.
I killed a man. What? Is that part of the test?
Begin secure transmission.
Here we go.
Good morning, 007. For the past 3 years, a high-ranking Russian general, Arkady Arumov, has been stealing Russian military equipment and selling it on the black market. We have reason to believe he's about to ship a cache of high-tech weapons to a terrorist organization that has been targeting our embassies. Along with Agent 006, your mission is to infiltrate his base of operations, destroy the weapons cache, and, if need be, eliminate General Arumov. Agent 006 has already surveyed the facility. Time is of the essence, 007. An unmarked cargo plane is already en route, due to pick up those weapons for the terrorists in 45 minutes. Do you copy?
Confirm. We're in position.
Good luck, James. MI6 out.
Nice. See, in a way, this is really nice to play this, because the new GoldenEye, the remaster of the N64 one's come out, and I've just played the original. But in a sense, this is almost like more modern than the one that's just come out. I'm not slating the one that's just come out, because I haven't even played it, and I can't wait to play it. But, you know, look at it. Like, this is... I'm certainly not slating the new one, because it was meant to be a remaster of the N64 anyway. Otherwise, they would have just made a new game, wouldn't they, like this? But this is really nice.
Welcome to Russia. MI6 has given us the go-ahead on the mission.
Let's wait until the last truck passes. I'll take the guard on the left. You take the one on the right.
What have we got? I can't just have my pistol from here. But I think I've got a sniper.
Now, let's go.
Yeah, in the film you don't find Trevelyan until he's already in the... I don't know. Yeah, he meets him when he's in the facility.
You take the tower, but watch out for that sniper. I'll get the truck.
I think it is actually Daniel Craig, I think. I don't know. Some of the voice actors are not too bad at doing the voices. And it sounded like Judi Dench before. Right. It's just cool as well, because it's like we know the levels already, you know? It's just what's really cool. Right. I was kind of hoping that was going to be binoculars. Nope, don't take that off. It's down here. Is it a way in? Oh. Yeah, they're collectibles. How do we get out of it? Oh no, I don't want to make this mission already boring or like already have to restart. You've got to be able to get up. Have you? Come on. You can't jump. Oh, right. Come on. Right. Mm-hmm. Oh, come on, let's restart. I love doing stealth, so I don't want it, like, literally at the first point just to be setting the alarms off. Right. I think we probably have to go down here, really, to not get seen. Oh, I thought that was a guard there. Against this wall. God. See, I definitely prefer doing stealth in third-person games. But then I suppose you could say it makes it a bit easier doing it in third-person. And actually, in first-person, you're seeing more or less, well, roughly what you would see in real life. Bad boy up. Oh. Oh, that didn't work like I thought it was going to.
Tower clear.
Oh no.
See if you can find any extra firepower in there.
Well, I found this. Damn it, man. Really, really wanted to be stealthy. Yes, I can handle it. Oh, what? Maybe, did he get rid of him? I'm confused. 1 minute, I heard some shots. Right, this bit, it looks like we've got to get in there. In here. Is that right? Or have I got to get in here? What? No, I've got to wait for the Trevelyan. Oh, shit. Oh, no. See now, they were bloody checking us out from over there.
Target's down.
Area clear. I'm moving to the truck.
Okay, we'll count that as like moving to your location. Stealth failed, but in the next section they couldn't have heard that or something. I like to do that in games where you can be stealth, but then they hear you and the alarms go off, but then it goes back to stealth. Okay. Although this bit, I think you do have to shoot a load of guards, and yeah, there's no choice.
Hurry up, diving too careful. Words to live by. So how much do you know about Orlamov?
Only what I read in the dossier. But after the fall of the Soviet Union, he became jealous of the oligarchs, all their new money, and went into business, freelancing for himself. Up ahead, the checkpoint. We're running 6 minutes behind. If anything goes wrong, be prepared to move. How's it rushing these days?
Gags it there, Harry Shaw.
Hey, T! Vihod is Gruzovika!
Почем продломе, Сардян?
Спецдоставка из Москвы. 15 минут никому двигался! Почему я никогда не видел тебя? Ты новый?
Первый день.
Давайте документы! Я сказал! Vihod is Gruzovika!
Let's get out of here, Alex!
Okay. Yeah, see, they've mapped everything, like, pretty well, like, you do recognise, like, oh, yeah, I recognise the second part you got to, and... Although I know there's not that much to have to model, I suppose, on the level. Oh, God. What? I got to admit, as soon as it kind of got to sort of 360... era, I'm really not terribly good at first person because everything is just so, I don't know, it's just all crazy. Everything's so smooth and like just everything happens so fast, if that makes sense. There he goes. Where's the checkpoint? At least we get checkpoints with this a bit more often. But again, sorry, I'm already having to redo parts. I was trying to talk to you guys, though, to be fair. That's why I got distracted. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I should change that. Just, yeah, the sensitivity. There we go. It's already on really low. But I think when it got to this generation of console, I did find it a bit hard going... Even though it's overall better controls, yeah, the sensitivity just being... I don't know. I think that's a bit better, actually. Doesn't seem to hold a lot of ammo, considering an AK. Right. Gotta get ready for that. Tanker. Right. There we go. Oh dear.
Whoa.
So obviously it's a bit different to like N64 on GoldenEye on N64 and the film itself, but it still seems really cool the way they've done this game.
Look, what the hell are they doing with one of those?
We haven't the time. Let's go. Come on, James. Let's move.
What the hell is happening up there? Have you heard anything new? Niet. It's probably just another surprise inspection.
Oh, it's going to be one of those siege things there that goes slow motion. Breach, yeah. Roar. There you go.
Did you see that helicopter?
Yeah. What of it?
It looked EMP hardened, designed to survive an electromagnetic pulse.
The blast from the weapons cache will take care of it.
I'm getting a picture for MI6.
Don't waste your time. You'll be late reaching the rendezvous point. Get on with it. I'll cover you.
What's going on with that? These shadows on the floor, what? Weird. Right. Okay, the sensitivity seems a little bit too slow when turning now. So, but it seemed alright before. It seems to, yeah, for just that one bar, that did quite a lot. So I don't know what that bar being on full would be like sensitivity-wise. It's crazy. Yeah, that felt really good, that sequence there, just killed them all stealthily. Ooh. I forget we're still on dam, I keep thinking we're in facility. Don't suppose it's going to let me through there, so let's go. Now, I'm like really impressed so far, even though I know I've played this before, just not for years. And apparently this came... Oh, damn. Oh, no, no. Ah, I don't think they'd actually seen me. I just started shooting because I thought, damn, they've already seen me. Oh, no. Yeah, they definitely see me now. Yeah, this came out in 2011, apparently, I think, it said at the start, which is just mental. I know it's not as far back as GoldenEye, but yeah, already 12 years ago, and it's just crazy. I'm really liking these levels. It's just a really good take on the whole dam level. There's just so much added, like, it seems. Alright, how are we going to do this? Like that. This is what I'm talking about. I think this is a good choice, actually, because I really was thinking, like I say, I had Nightfire in the console ready to go. And I really did think it might be good to just play something that's a little bit more modern. I know it's still Xbox 360, so it's still, like, well, two generations behind, because obviously there's Xbox One and then Xbox Series X. So I'm still two generations behind, but this is still moving forward from PS2 and N64. Oh, what? Oh, no. Where are they coming from? Are they coming from in here? From down here, even? Yes. Let's try the Cygnus. I think we already did. Oh no, maybe not. Not in a mission so far, I don't think. Right.
Have you found your precious helicopter yet, Bond?
Yeah, I just... I really am pleased with choosing to do this game now. And I really do think it makes even more sense and is even nicer having done GoldenEye recently. Pretty sure there's some time challenges in this as well, like getting through this part in a certain time on a certain difficulty. Well, probably the whole level, to be fair, not just certain parts. Okay. Oh, what we... Some objectives require you to take a photo or some objectives require you to take photos of objects or people using a smartphone. Press down on a D-pad to take out your smartphone. Position yourself so that you have a perfect shot and hold X. Right. When you see the flashing smartphone icon to the right of the radar, you are being alerted to a nearby... Yeah, that's like collectibles, basically. It's telling you roughly where a collectible is. Okay, so... Oh. There we go. What do we have to get three pictures? Oh, yeah. Oh, right. Yeah, we need to get pictures of certain things, right. There's things like this in Bond games, which I don't really mind, but a lot of people would think like this really slows down the whole pace of, you know, an action game. I think it adds to the game and the story. Meet me at the rendezvous. We're running out of time. Ooh, here come the men with their guns. Oh. I didn't realise they were already there. Right, let's get them before they can get us. Possibly. Oh dear. I think the Cygnus hasn't got a very big magazine. Although the AK didn't seem to have much in terms of having a big magazine. Oh, damn. What? Okay. Yeah, I really do love this game. Well, I'm really enjoying this game, I should say, so far. Yeah, I'm really, really liking it. I like how they've done this. Right, is there something we've got to do in here? Oh, shit. Oh, look at that. I'm not the greatest sniper, but I do enjoy sniping. Coming up for me. There he is. Hold on, right. Okay, we got to go. Oh, we got to go below. Okay. Yeah, this is just like obviously on N64, going down to do something with those computers. Ragdolling there.
Ah, damn. You'd have thought that after the fall of communism, the Russians might have invested in some 21st century transportation by now.
I don't think I've got any grenades or anything. Oh, no, it's Trevelyan. Shit. Oh, it's a big jump.
Get your hands in the air.
Take off your parachute.
If you insist.
Yeah.
See reflections on the water, more than darkness in the depths. See himself as never a shadow. On the winds I feel his breath. Golden eye found his weakness. Golden eye will do what I please. Golden eye, no time for sweetness. But a bitter kiss will bring him to his knees. You'll never know.
Yeah, some of these intro scenes like they do in the films, but the game versions are really good. Yeah, so it is Daniel Craig and Judi Dench, which is pretty cool. Even Q, I swear, sounded like the new Q, the young Q. Yeah.
Nice trick. Doing it without a parachute. Trying to show me up.
You said we were running late. Let's move.
Hey, James. For England?
For England, Alec. Always for England.
Here we are. Okay. So I'm going to leave it there. I don't know what happens when you press continue, if it gives you stats or anything, but we'll know by the next video whether I can press continue and it doesn't actually take us into the next mission, because I think it might. So yeah, we'll leave it there. So that's the tutorial and first level. I really can't wait to play the rest of this game now. Just think it was a perfect choice. So I usually upload maybe 2 or 3 levels a day. I don't mean I do it every day necessarily, but when I do some of these videos, I usually upload about 2 or 3 missions a day, or I record 2 or 3 missions a day and then upload them. But I'm going to just do the one today. This will be up tonight. Not that, I don't know why I'm saying this, because it doesn't really matter, does it? Me saying this will be up tonight doesn't mean anything. But hope you enjoyed that, guys, and hope you enjoyed seeing GoldenEye as well. Like, if you didn't know about this game, because a lot of people might just have, all they might know of GoldenEye games is the original N64 one and then the remaster recently. And it just seems like, you know, I've played one level of it so far, but it seems really well done, and I sort of forgot about it, really. Played it before, but yeah, just played through the once, I think. And there's a few other challengey things you can do in it. But apart from that, yeah. But it seems like pretty well produced, and like it's got a good budget behind it. But it is Bond, so it would, I suppose. So yeah. I'll see you in the next mission for Facility. Again.